Hey guys, Angler here. Welcome back to Wild Arms 4. In the last part, we went through the Great Stairway. Now we'll check out the place we came here for in the first place, the White Orphanage. Given that this is an actual dungeon, I remember this place being pretty long. So now we're talking about gods. Anyway, let's just check this place out. Well, we got a torch and a door we can't go through. Looks suspicious, but we can't deal with it yet, so we're going up. I guess we'll just go straight through, because we can't go anywhere else. And we already have a boss. Or, I mean, an enemy. No, I was thinking of the boss that... Actually...
My turn to show off.
No, I was... Probably thinking of a boss of a completely different area, actually. I just got confused, because of how similar they looked.
My turn! Do you really think you can catch me? How predictable. I want to help. How predictable. This should be interesting.
When in doubt, use intrude. Or not, because that was outright pathetic. Yeah, it kind of sucks when you only have one character that uses attack magic, and you have to fight enemies that only take damage from said magic. Like, this is just a thought, but... Maybe they should have made some of Jude's ranged attacks count as magic, too. Like, I don't know, it feels kind of weird to have a giant laser beam count as a physical attack. I'll move over here.
I'll stir things up.
That wasn't very much XP. Anyway, now we have a door and a switch. Or another battle.
Try using your brain a little.
Thank goodness for move and attack.
Where to go?
Cool and smart, that's my way.
I mean, granted, every character can move an attack in 5, but... ugh, this isn't 5!
The one that got away always looks the biggest.
So now we know how to stomp, which we need to do to activate the switch. Also, isn't Muir's the encounter rate in this dungeon really high? Like, I'm running into an enemy like every other step. To have. Oh well. Jude really doesn't get it. So what do we have here?
If I use this.
We have the Wonder Staff and a sword. Let's break the boxes with the sword. Like, I remember that what I was supposed to do for this puzzle was to bring the Wonder Staff to some other room and light it on fire, but... I don't remember where the torch is. Great, and we got more enemies to deal with.
Fire!
We're okay, let's see what I can do.
And the worst part is that they all spawned in separate spaces too.
Holding back. Let's do it!
Well, that was a dumb idea.
Let's do this smartly. Feel the blaze of wind.
Let's just finish this thing off already.
All I did was lend my strength to beautiful bonds of friendship.
And Yuli gets an HP penalty for dying. Alright, the menu circle. As you can see, her health is in blue, meaning she doesn't have her full max health. Now, was there some sort of torch in here? Doesn't look like it. It is pretty nice that you can abuse Accelerator so that you don't have to fight random battles.
Time's up.
What's that? That doesn't seem bad. Because at the moment, I'm kind of stuck, like... I know what I need to do, but I don't know where the torch is.
I can't push it any further!
At least there's a pretty good chain I got going. Wow, so many random scientific terms. Well, now I feel stupid. You have to access the machine to get the torch to light. Well, now we can go through. You don't need a turn. And that's it. We're done.
Looks like it's payday.
That went pretty well. So let's see what's through this door. Supposed to be. So yeah, we got more torches. And we have another battle to tend to. We did it. Well, let's go back up here. And then we got a side scroller section.
Whoa!
Card would have been nice, but whatever. And we're back to 3D movement. I had no idea what I just picked up. Going back this way, I guess, because there was nothing we could do in the last room.
I'll do my best.
Come on. This chance. My turn. turn to show off. I'm pretty confident in everything from the neck up. Blast!
Well, that didn't work.
They're tougher than I thought.
My turn to show off!
Now I just need to press on for the win! Come on!
There we go.
Lose.
Yeah, this'll kill him.
Set up formula. Am I this much of a softie? Why am I getting mixed up in this?
So let's get through here. That's supposed to be.
What the? It's functional. How can that be?
Well, I remember someone reactivating the facility.
Now it's my fault?
This isn't the time, you two. If you stand there arguing, it's going to get us.
So it has no weakness. Wonderful.
Let's see.
Well, okay, let's see what I can do. Set up formula.
Sorry, try again.
I don't think this is actually going to do all that much more damage, or... Actually, no. That was quite a bit.
My turn to show off!
But Raquel's dead and isn't coming back into the fight. Now Jude's dead. Wow, and that was literally the last of Arnode's MP too.
Did their research produce this thing?
Yeah, which is why it was called Miscreation. That's sad. So with that painful flashback done, let's keep going. So, there's all this evolution stuff. But, screw that. We have a save point, so I'll end the part off here. Next time on Wild Arms 4, we'll continue through this dungeon. See you guys then.